O most exceeding bitter cry from ashen lips in anguish curled. O body that on Calvary the sword of death devours. O river red that pours and winds a bloody bandage round the wounded world. O cup they made to overflow, whereat our Saviour drinks his fill. O crown upon that piteous brow, with scarlet buds of scorn amid the twisted thorn. O bloody passion rose upon the sanguine hill. Christ upon the rood hath broke the bands and shattered death, and lo, the rod hath pierced and bruised his holy hands. Come hither, ye that mourn, and see what he hath borne. Behold the purple wound within the breast of God.
Thank you.
Come, brave soldiers, come and see mighty love's artillery. This was the conquering dart, and lo, there shines his quiver, there his bow. These the passive weapons are that made great love a man of war. The quiver that he bore did bide so near, it proved his very side. In it there sat but one sole dart, a piercing one, his pierced heart. His weapons were not steel nor brass. The weapon that he wore, he was. For bow his unbent head did serve, well strung with many a broken nerve. Strange the quiver, bow and dart, a bloody side and head and heart. But now the field is won, and they, the dust of war quite wiped away, the weapons now of triumph be, that were before of victory.
Thank you.
What is this strange and uncouth thing to make me sigh and seek and faint and die until I had some place where I might sing and serve thee? And not only I, but all my wealth and family might combine to set thy honor up as our design. And then, when after much delay, much wrestling, many a combat, this dear end, so much desired, is given, to take away my power to serve thee, to unbend all my abilities, my designs confound, and lay my threatenings bleeding on the ground. One ague dwelleth in my bones, another in my soul. The memory what I would do for thee, if once my groans could be allowed for harmony. I am in all a weak, disabled thing, save in the sight thereof, where strength doth sting. Besides, things sought not to my will, even when my will doth study thy renown. Thou turnest the edge of all things on me still, taking me up to throw me down, so that even when my hopes seem to be sped, I am to grief alive, to them as dead. To have my aim and yet to be farther from it then when I bent my bow, to make my hopes my torture and the fee of all my woes another woe, is in the midst of delicates to need, and even in paradise to be a weed. Ah, my dear father, ease my smart. These contrarieties crush me. These cross actions do wind a rope about and cut my heart. And yet, since these thy contradictions are properly a cross felt by thy son, with but four words, my words, thy will be done.
Sing, Lord, and Lord, 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 Sing, Lord, and Lord,
They bruised his back with many a rod, but the bitterest stroke was thine own, O God. Girt with thy glory to earth he came. They bound his brows with a torturous flame. The flowers and grass of the garden were wet. Save us, O God, for his bloody sweat. They bruised his back with many a rod, but the bitterest stroke was thine own, O God. His flesh was nailed to the naked rood. Save us, O God, for the price of his blood. Now pleading before thy throne he stands. Save us, O God, for his pierced hands. They bruised his back with many a rod, but the bitterest stroke was thine own, O God.